Hello, thank you for making time to watch this video. Ghana's $43 billion economy is supported by oil, gold, and cocoa, and the government of Ghana is exploring the tourism sector to ensure that the sector contributes its best to the economy. Travel and tourism grew by 7% last year, and the central region is home to a number of tourist sites in the country. The Elmina Castle, the famous Kakum National Park with all its greenery and wild, and the Cape Coast Castle are a few of these sites. I am currently at the Cape Coast Castle. This magnificent, huge imposition you see behind me here was built in 1653. It is among the over 40 castles that were built in the Gold Coast to serve as holding points for slaves before they finally exited into the Caribbean and the Americas. Each day, thousands of people troop into the Cape Coast Castle. Not just that, Africans in the diaspora also use this as a learning point for a bit of their history to reconnect with both known and unknown ancestors. Both tourists and Africans in the diaspora bring money to support the economy of Ghana as they explore the opportunities in the castle. Overlooking the boisterous Atlantic Ocean is the Fosu Lagoon. This lagoon features prominently in the economic and cultural life of the people in Cape Coast. The city of Bonn, Germany, and the Cape Coast Metropolitan Assembly are currently collaborating to renaturate this lagoon to contribute its best to tourism in Ghana. And this is pure nature. The well-laid ocean front stretching from Winneba to Commander, about 300 kilometers of a beachfront, and revelers certainly love this. But the Ghana Tourism Authority is facing a huge challenge of human behavior, open defecation, and indiscriminate littering. The political and traditional heads in this metropolis are brainstorming on the best solution for this problem. I am here at the Emitimazi Palace. This is the seat of the traditional authority in the Cape Coast metropolis. A couple of weeks ago, the chiefs and elders of this metropolis set up a 58-member task force to look into the problems of indiscriminate littering and open defecation affecting the tourism sector. I'm here to speak with the chief of the Cape Coast traditional area, Osabere Makwisiata II, to look into the mandate of the task force.
The main objective of this task force is to make sure that the beach line of Cape Coast is kept clean and healthy for anyone, including our tourists, to have a free walk without any problems at the beach and make it healthy as well.
The World Travel and Tourism Council estimate that the sector will grow on an annual rate of 4.5% in Ghana between 2018 and 2024, and across Africa, 4.9%. Looking at Ghana's huge tourism potential, there is a high possibility that Ghana could match or beat this rate. Reporting from Cape Coast, Ghana, my name is Mary Ama Bawa.